Even the simplest cytometer can detect up to 4 fluorochromes at a time, using 1 or 2 lasers. However, different fluorochromes may be read as one through the same detector. In that case, we need a cytometer which can detect the differences in fluorochromes. It is also important to know which fluorochromes our laser can excite in order to determine the right dye. For instance, the PMT tube cannot see the difference between the FITC and Alexa 488 fluorochromes. Not all fluorochromes emit light in the same intensity. Stronger emitters in generally produce better separation between the background signal and positive signal. We can get an idea of the fluorochrome's ability to separate background and positive signal by measuring the stain index. The ratio between peak distance, D, and the width of the positive peak, W. The higher the stain index is, the better separation. Dilution of antibodies is a standard procedure in flow cytometry for economical as well as technical reasons. For example, background subtraction, an error which occurs by having excess antibodies in our sample, may occur if the fluorochromes are not diluted enough. Flow cytometry can be used to detect proteins instead of classical ELISA. The beads with different fluorescent intensity can detect up to 20 different proteins at the same time. The beads are linked to antibodies, which in turn binds, for example, cytokines. PE conjugated antibody are then bound to the cytokine. The cytometer reading are proportional to the amount of cytokines in the sample. The intensity of the PE signal correlates to the concentration of cytokine.